This is your AESH Electric Energy News Minute for Tuesday, June 1, 2021. In mainstream news, CNBC reports, Europe's ports will need $7.9 billion of investment to support offshore wind expansion, report says. European ports will require new infrastructure and significant investment over the next few years to cope with the growth of the region's offshore wind sector, according to a new report from industry body WindEurope. In its report, published on Thursday, the Brussels-based organization said Europe's ports would have to invest 6.5 billion euros, around $7.9 billion, by 2030 in order to support the expansion of offshore wind. Bloomberg headline, Solar is one bank's answer to Nigerian electricity blackouts. The manager of Nigeria's biggest pension fund is teeing up millions in financing for the renewable sector, but it's also embracing solar energy for the good of its own business. Standard Bank Group Limited's Nigerian unit is aiming to run nearly half its offices on solar by 2022 to cut down on energy costs and dependence on diesel-powered generators in the West African nation, which suffers from acute power shortages and frequent blackouts. The Financial Times reports. Latest U.S. energy merger creates $17 billion oil and gas group. Wall Street Journal headline, Ford expects 40% of global vehicle volume to be fully electric by 2030. Ford Motor Company shares rose to their highest level in nearly 5 years after the automaker outlined a tech-centric strategy to electrify much of its vehicle lineup and sharply grow its commercial truck and van business. Ford said it plans to boost spending on electric vehicle development to $30 billion by 2025, roughly one-third more than it forecast earlier this year. The increase in spending a total that includes some money spent in the past few years is driven by Ford's plans to eventually begin manufacturing its own batteries, including at two future U.S. battery cell factories, with Korea's SK Innovation Company. Forbes headline, The Day the Energy World Changed. May 26, 2021 was the day the energy world changed. On the same day that a Dutch court in The Hague ruled that Royal Dutch Shell could be held liable for climate change, and ordered it to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions by 45% by the end of 2030 compared to 2019 levels. BBC reports, wind power, go forth and multiply. Offshore wind is picking up pace, with prospects for tens of thousands of jobs, if the potential is tapped, or a drop in offshore energy, if it is not, according to a new report. Forth Ports is setting out its stall, with £40 million investment in Leith Docks buying a large ship berth, strengthened storage, and a vast area for new supply and manufacturing jobs. EnergyLiveNews.com reports, TenneT launches €1.8 billion green bonds. European grid operator TenneT has launched a green bond of €1.8 billion, £1.5 billion. Proceeds from the issue will be used to support green power transmission projects in the Netherlands and Germany, designed to connect offshore wind farms to the onshore electricity grid. The bond, which is split into three tranches, has the support of six joint bookrunners, including BNP Paribas, Deutsche Bank and HSBC. Investors from 20 European countries have placed orders of approximately €4 billion, £3.4 billion, the company said. PowerGrid.com reports, Blackstone's ClearGen providing $500 million for GreenStructure renewable microgrid development in U.S. GreenStructure is partnering with ClearGen to develop and operate as many as 120 microgrids nationwide. GreenStructure is a joint venture with Schneider Electric and Huck Capital. ClearGen is committing $500 million in long-term capital toward the projects. This capital commitment is through funds managed by Blackstone, owner of Clarion Energy and Power Engineering. This has been your AESH Electric Energy News Minute for June 1, 2021. If you want more global electric energy news and real-time alerts, hit the subscribe button now and follow us on social media.